background with what they're going to talk about. Last fall, I had a meeting with the nurses, and I asked them a question. I said, suppose you were at the store, grocery store, drug store, and you were in your smock, your white smock with the logo on it, and someone came up and asked you, what is it you do? I asked them that question, and they looked at each other, and they looked at me, and they said, well, they said a lot. And they said, well, I guess I could tell them that we visit people, and we help teach people. And they kept going on and on and on. And I said, look, let me make it very simple for you. The next time someone asks you what you do, you just tell them the truth. You tell them that you save lives. And they couldn't believe I was saying this, and the profundity of this. And I said, in fact, you do. Every time you go to the house of a child with asthma, and you educate the parents, you assess the child, you teach the parents about the medication, and you encourage them to make sure they bring that child back to the doctor, you save a life. Every time you go to visit a diabetic and teach that individual about their illness and how to take their medication and make sure they go back to the doctor, you're saving lives. Every time you visit a teen mom who has just had a baby, a mom who doesn't know her adenoids from her elbow, and teach her how to feed that child, and how to care for that child, and how to prepare that child for school, you are saving lives. And interestingly enough, they took me seriously. Not only that, but they begin to research and ask themselves, what else can we do to save lives? And I gave them some data on the simple act of hand washing. And they researched it further, and they found out about a Dr. Semmelweis, a Hungarian physician who in the 19th century taught doctors the importance of washing hands, because during that time, women frequently died after childbirth. But doctors didn't connect the dots and realize that when they came from the autopsy room, maybe they should wash their hands before they went to the delivery room. They didn't get it until he suggested to them strongly, that's what you should do. They did a lot of work on hand washing. They got more and more excited. I got excited. They said, we can really save lives in Monterey County. So on their own time, using their own money, they bought soap. They bought what we'd call a portable sink cobbled together over at Ace Hardware. And they started going around the county. They went to labor camps in South County. They went to bi-national events in Pajaro. They went to neighborhood events in Salinas. They went to Boys and Girls Club all over this county. And the more they did, the more excited they got. During the H1N1 season, we partnered with the Monterey County Office of Education to teach kids about hand washing. We had a poster contest. All the kids from kindergarten to grade 5 competed throughout Monterey County. We chose the winners with the help of KSBW, and kids start to understand the importance of hand washing. We then partners with KSBW. We put together a public service announcement. Some of you may have seen it already. A neat jingle, unique, put together with a group in Florida. We partnered with KION. And our most recent partner, Visiting Nurses Association. You're all familiar with the Visiting Nurses Association. They go out to do clinical work I know some of you have experienced that. They do hospice. They work with us on immunizations. They got excited about this hand-washing campaign. We wanted to come here today to share it with you, and hopefully when we leave, you will be our partner in spreading this news about the importance of our most important yet least expensive public health intervention, and that's washing hands. I'd like to introduce to you the CEO of the Visiting Nurses Association, Mr. Steve Johnson.
Good afternoon, Mayor Donahue and council members. I appreciate the time that you're giving us to talk about a very important public health issue. And another point I'd like to mention in addition to you, and I'm not going to take a lot of time because he has clearly explained it, and the nurses will make it even clearer with the value and the needs of this program. But partnering around these types of issues, particularly in public health issues and community health issues, are imperative. As you mentioned, we have partnered in the past with the health department to assist in immunizations and the like. And we find that the resources that we have, in addition to the outstanding resources of the public health nurses and the health department, really allow us to expand and assist the needs of our community, Salinas and the rest of Monterey County. And we're very excited to be a part of this partnership going forward. We are a 60-year-old organization that prides ourselves on our outreach in our community and our community health. Partnering with these outstanding folks in the health department and the nurses and the like really, I think, will allow all of us to be even more involved and supportive in a very basic but a very important fact in public health, and that is hand washing. It's astounding to look at the statistics of the value of doing a project like this, and to have these folks here take their own time to do this really makes my heart sing, and I wanted to really appreciate you and allow these folks to talk a little bit about the program and make a presentation, but also to thank you for your support going forward in this project and appreciate your time. We're honored to be here, and thank you very much. Now I'd like to introduce the Linda, I think, and the nurses to present the program. Linda Payne, and again, thank you very much.
Good afternoon, Mayor Donahue and the council. My name is Linda Payne. I am a public health nurse for the Monterey County Health Department, and I've been the chairperson and the lead nurse in this endeavor. Today I want to tell you a little bit, and then I'm going to show you just a little bit of a PowerPoint, and then we will be done. Why hand washing? Well, it's already been told to us today that it is one of the basic, most least expensive ways that we can help our community, help you, help your children, help your family, help our city to become healthy. We are here today because we want the city of Salinas in concept to support this project as we move forward. It is our hope that our first hand washing station be established here in Monterey County in one of our wonderful and beautiful parks. We already know that the most important thing that we can do to keep from becoming sick is to wash our hands. According to the Center for Disease Control, it is the most simple and basic way to do that. In case you didn't know, approximately 22 million school days are lost annually due to the common cold. And the common cold is transferred from touch. So today we want to tell you a little bit about our hand washing campaign. It was a pilot project, and we worked with the Girls and Boys Club. We visited them in November of 2009, and we developed some interesting strategies. We assessed the knowledge and behavior with a pre intervention survey, and we provided 4-minute trainings to all of the students who participated. And one of the three of the things we focused on were just basic hand washing skills, knowledge of critical situations requiring hand washing, and the barriers to frequent and effective hand washing. We wanted to demonstrate how to wash your hands effectively to our children and to adults, which were the group leaders at the Girls and Boys Club, and that was on our first intervention. When we came back on the second visit, we used interactive hand washing interventions, which demonstrated unwashed hand portions of the hands. It was called glow glue, and we used a black light, and it showed where, after they did the demonstration, where there was still germs on your hands. This is a picture of our germ farm, because if you look at your hands right now, there are lots of bacteria and germs on your hands. So when you go to sip your coffee, make sure you don't stick your thumb in your mouth. We don't want you to get sick. And it's interesting, when we had our data analyzed by our epidemiologists, it's interesting to find out that average range of age was 6 to 13. There were the boys averaged 8.1 years of age, and the girls 8.6. But it's interesting that 87% of the girls knew the correct way to wash their hands before we even tried to teach them. However, there was only 60% of the boys who knew how to do it correctly before the intervention. So, just a little tip, boys. Make sure you're learning how to correctly wash your hands. We have a PowerPoint. One of our goals, and that's why we're here today. We're here because we want you to understand we have been volunteering our time, our resources, and our energies into this effort. Volunteerism is something that this nation is starting to, that's a big resource that we're trying to capitalize on. And one of the basic goals that we want here, and we want the city council to adopt with us, is one city-owned hand washing station here in the city of Salinas. This might be the very first county in the state of California, might even be in the nation. If you see our vision and can partner with us and put your stamp of approval on this venture, we might be making history. We want a freestanding, maintained hand washing station, and we're going to tell you that we know that the city is, we know that the counties are broke. We understand that, but we have innovative ways that we're going to be able to work together, and we will find the funding. The next slide. We want to empower our community, because when you have empowered community and citizens, then you get change. We want to educate our community. Without education, that young man who just had that 4.60 is not going to go to Harvard. It's about educating our community so that we can heighten the awareness of just what basic hand washing can do. We taught them the process, and it's very simple. You just wet your hands, and you gotta soap up really good, and do it for a minimum of 20 seconds. We've been advertising this in the jingle that we have going on. We're teaching. Right here you can see some pictures. We were basically started out with some buckets that were given to us, one from Ace Hardware and another from Orchard. And the gentleman who sold it to us plugged a hole in it, put a little spigot on it, and we were carrying buckets around on tables, and we were going into community events. That's how we started out. And it was very effective. We got quite a response from the community. We have our banner, and we display it as the Monterey County Health Department. And in the pictures, you'll see the nurses. They're volunteering. These are all volunteers. And we're just trying to teach everybody how to wash your hands more effectively. We have collaborated and joined forces with one of the largest community health organizations here in the county, and that is with the Visiting Nurses Association. We're extremely excited about it. It's about the community. It's about where we live.